In this video, we're going to discuss how you can upload a video to YouTube. And in the previous videos, we showed how to do that from iMovie. But in this video, we're going to assume that we have already got an exported video from iMovie or from whatever software you're using. Before we jump into the video, I just want to tell you guys about a special promo we have for Skillshare. You can get 30 days free access to all of the premium content. So they have great courses on how to create YouTube content from scratch, from YouTube masterclasses to branding, all of it for completely free using the link in the description below. So make sure to use that link and get all of this content for free. So let's go back to the video now. So once you are signed into your YouTube account, you should come to this icon at the very top and it says create. And that will give you this drop down where you can upload a video. And you also have the option to go live there if you want to do a live stream. But we're just going to click on this create button. And if you go to your dashboard, so I'm on my channel dashboard here. This is a secondary channel that I have. You can see that the create button is much bigger in here. And once you click it, you will get this overlay. And this overlay allows you to simply drop a file here, or you can click the button and use the finder to locate the file that you want to upload. But in this case, I'm just going to click the file and drag it onto this window. And once you do that, then it will start automatically uploading your video clip. And while that's uploading and processing, you're able to go into the details here and just fill out the title of your video, the description. So you can say like a few sentences about to describe what the video is about. And all of these details will be populated once the video has uploaded. So it's trying to process a video right now. But once it's completed, you will see these thumbnails and you can simply select them. And if you scroll down further on this window, you will see there are more options. So you can attach your own thumbnail, but if you scroll down, you can do the playlists. Once you click show more details, it allows you to add tags for your videos. So this is a very good way for people to find your videos on YouTube. So you simply type the word and press comma or return, and it will break into a secondary word. So you can have multiple tags here to describe your video. And you can also copy and paste in words. So in this case, if you have comma separated words, you can just copy and paste it in and it will automatically convert them into keywords for you. So underneath them, we can select the language. So in this case, I want to set this to English. This just helps the search for your video. So if you set these details correctly, it means that people can search for English only videos, for example. Other than this, you can set the category. So this is relevant to allowing people to find your content, your videos. But most of these things you can set by default under your channel, but you can also change them on a video by video basis. Another important thing to note here is the age of the content for the audience. So if you scroll down a little bit, there's an audience section that has been added quite recently. So in this case, we want to make sure that this is not set specifically for kids. And you can also add on the second step, then you can add subtitles or you can add cards to your video. So you can also just upload your video first and add these subtitles or cards later. You don't have to do it at this point. So at this stage, once we go to the third screen, we're seeing this checks. So they have to check our video to make sure that it is safe to upload this type of content. And in order to make that work, we need to allow the video to process first. But you can continue to the next step. So what will happen if you do that is that the processing will still happen after you've uploaded the video. So we'll still be checking to see if it is if it passes all the checks before it can be monetized, for example. But normally when I get to this final stage, I will just list the video as unlisted. And that means that it's uploaded to your account, but it won't be published to your channel. And the reason I like to do that is you may want to go back afterwards. I normally go back afterwards and add like a custom thumbnail, modify the description, turn on advertising, different things like that you can do afterwards that you may not want to do just at this moment. So if you go ahead and click the finish button, you can see that the video is still uploading right now. And it's telling us that there's approximately 8 minutes left to complete the upload. So that will happen in the background and you can see it at the bottom right of our screen now. So you can continue just using the website and it will continue to upload in the background. So if you go to the content section on the left navigation, you will see that the visibility is pending and the video is still processing. It's still uploading, in fact, and we can't really do anything with this video until it is finished uploading. So once it is finished uploading, then we can modify all of the details within that video. So I fast forward a little bit at this point. So now the video is just finishing the upload. So if we click on the video name at the bottom of the screen, so now that it is finished uploading, if we click on it, it will take us directly into that video and we can update the details there. So let's give this a click. And now we can modify all of the details here. So we can change the title, description. Even though the video is finished uploading now, it's still being processed, and that's why we don't see all of the screenshots, all of the thumbnails available. Normally I like to leave it maybe 10 minutes or so to allow the video to finish processing before I would go and edit any video. So it's good to just upload it in advance and come back to it a little while later. And that way you're not waiting for the screen or for the thumbnails to process and things like that. But after a few minutes, this will appear like this. It will show it's processing the HD version. And you can still modify some of the details. You can modify the title, the description, etc. But it's just for the thumbnails that this is a bit of a problem at this point. So once the video has fully uploaded and fully finished the processing, you will see that there's a default thumbnail. So it will pick one automatically for you, whichever one YouTube feels is the most appropriate thumbnail it will pick for you. And at this point, we can come in and modify everything. So we should be able to just make whatever changes we want at this point and then boot the video live. So any of the settings that we have changed at the upload stage, we can also modify them here. But if you want to boot the video live, you go to this save or publish section and make this public. So once it's public, it will automatically send out notification to all of your subscribers who have the notifications turned on. And it will also mean that your video can be found in search on YouTube and it will appear on the homepage of your subscribers. If you want to learn more about how to create content for YouTube, check out the Skillshare link in the description below. You can find courses on YouTube for Beginners, YouTube Masterclass, and also how to brand yourself for YouTube. So there's lots of great video courses on Skillshare, and using the link in the description below, you can get 30 days of premium access to all of these courses for completely free. So check that link out in the description below. Hopefully you have found this video helpful. If you have, make sure to give this video a like and subscribe to the channel for more videos. And I will see you guys in the next one.